This is part two of percents, and in this video we're going to write percents as decimals. And in part one of percents, the meaning of percents, we learned that percent, think of that as per 100 or out of 100 or parts of 100, basically means you divide by 100. So you can replace the percent sign with divide by 100. So here's an example, 58%. You could take that percent sign and rewrite it. So if you remove the percent sign, it means 58 divided by 100. So you could just write divide by 100. Now, when you divide by 100, you just could move the decimal two places to the left. This is a whole number. So if we went two to the left, this would be 0.58 once you simplified it. So 58% is the same thing as 0.58. It means 58 hundredths. That's what 50% means, 58 out of 100. Now, you don't need to do this middle step right here. This is optional step to write, but that just is showing the meaning. All right, we're going to do some more complicated problems now. So when it's a two-digit number like this, 58, 32, they're all going to be the same. But we're going to work with some more problems that might have some fractions in it, might have some other decimals in it, etc. All right, here's four problems. We want to write each of those that are in percent form as decimals. So put the video on pause and try these four problems first on your own. Okay, hope you're back. All right, so how do we do this first one? 4.9%. We're dividing by 100, or move the decimal two to the left. That'll be 0.049. Second one, 703. You don't see the decimal, but remember it's at the end, so when you move it two to the left, because that's what you would do by dividing by 100, that gives you 7.03. Notice that's more than the number 1. 100% is actually the same as 1. So 703% is big number. It's 7. All right, what about this third one? Move the decimal 2 to the left. This is a very small number, 0.41%. This is less than 1%. So when you write it as a decimal, you move the decimal 2 places to the right, you get 0.0041. It's a very, very small number. And 86.3%, you move it to the left too, should have 0.863%. So hopefully you're doing fine and it's making sense so far. Let's do a problem that might have a fraction involved. All right, write each percent as a decimal. We'll just start with the first one, 4.5%. Well, you could just move the decimal 2 to the left, but in general, you try not to mix decimals and fractions together. And so we can change that 1/2 to just a decimal first. And hopefully you remember how to change 1/2 to a decimal. It's the same as 0.5. So this is the same as 4.5%. So all I'm doing, I'm not changing the percent to a decimal yet. All I'm doing is rewriting 4.5 is 4.5. And now I can change this to a decimal by just moving it 2 to the left, 0.045. So 4.5% is written as 0.045. All right, so try this one. Rewrite 18¼% as a decimal using the same technique. So put the video on pause. You're going to first have to figure out what 1/4 is as a decimal. All right, 1/4. Well, you could divide 4 into 1.00, do long division, or most of you probably know that's 0.25. I think of it as a fourth of a dollar, which is a quarter, which is written as 0.25. So this is 18.25. I'm just rewriting the 1/4 is 0.25. I still have my percent sign. And now, to get rid of the percent sign, to rewrite this percent as a decimal, now I need to move the decimal 2 to the left, so it's 0.1825. All right, here's a little bit trickier one. What if I said 13 and one-third percent? This one we cannot write solely as a decimal unless we want to round. So this is a tricky one. And so you would have to sort of like be given maybe a few more directions. So one-third, if you tried dividing one-third, making it as a decimal, it's a repeating decimal. So you can't write that just as a decimal without rounding it. But you can just move it 2 to the left and write 0.13 and a third. So this is sort of mixed, right? So some people might accept that answer. The other way to do it is you would have to round. So if you were going to round to the nearest, let's say, tenth of a percent, first, you would need to write the 13 one-third as some repeating decimals. So let's go out. I don't know how many places I'm going to go out. I'm going to put dot, 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 which means it's going on forever. And now I'm going to move the decimal 2 to the left. So that'll be 0.133. I made a mistake. I meant to write, we're not rounding, making it into a percent. We're going to round to the nearest, let's say, thousandth. Right, so I first would, I know this goes on and on, right, when I move my decimal 2 to the left, but it says round to the nearest thousandth, so that's 3 places after the decimal point. So if you were going to round it, we would write 0.133. That is the decimal rounded to the nearest thousandths. So it can get a little bit tricky, especially if you have a repeating decimal when you're trying to convert your fraction. So usually, if you are given a problem like this, 13 and a third percent, you can write it in exact form as a fraction, not in exact form as a decimal, unless you just wrote 0.13 and one-third. That's actually exact, but as you notice, it really isn't purely a decimal. So a little bit tricky. So I think now you're ready for the next video, which is how do you write a percent as a fraction. You could take any percent, and it's always possible to write it as an exact fraction, unlike this problem, 13 and a third percent, impossible to write it as an exact decimal with no fractions involved. This is part 2 of percents, and we're writing percents as decimals, and we do the following 8 problems on this video, changing each of these percents to a decimal.